So I'm here with Cameron Richman. He is a member of the University of Portland Pilots baseball team. But this summer, he's also going to be coaching the Salem Salamanders, part of the new Cascade Collegiate League. And so, Cameron, right off the bat, you know, you're playing at the college level, but you're going to be transitioning pretty quickly into coaching. What things are you personally hoping to achieve and hoping to learn this summer as you go into coaching?
Yeah, I think I just kind of want to get a good gauge on what it's like being a coach and getting that transition, like you said. And I just really want to help these kids and kind of just pass on that knowledge I've learned from the Division I level playing baseball and just pass those guys along so they can learn and grow and be able to compete in the spring for their teams.
And you mentioned, you know, Division I, you get to play against some pretty good teams here in the Northwest. You played against Washington. You know, they've had some World Series teams. Oregon State obviously has had, you know, even championship teams. What's it like to face that level of competition and to see guys who are really destined for Major League Baseball here at the college level?
I think it's for everyone on my team, speaking for all of them. Like, it's our favorite games of the year when we get to play those type of teams. We finally get to see all the work we paid off and see like how we rank up against those type of teams. And a lot of teams don't get the chance to play the top level programs in the country like we do, and every year we get to play a couple games against Oregon State, who's always a national contender, and we get to play other really good teams in the Pac-12. So it's really special being able to play those type of teams and see what we got.
And then, you know, you are here at University of Portland. You've had some pretty good seasons, you know, over your career here. What is a moment or a memory that you look at and say, you know, that's probably the time I most enjoyed being on the field for this team?
I think any time we beat Oregon State is always fun, and Oregon, just because our in-state rivals. So anytime we can kind of tick up and be at the top of the rankings in Oregon is a really good feeling.
And then for you coming up, you actually in high school won, you know, three state titles. You pitched in those three games. But then that transition from high school to college, that's a big change. And even kind of the high school you went to was kind of a smaller school. So first, what was it like to win those state titles? And then how was it in that transition that happened to what things did you have to realize when you came to college ball?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, winning a championship at any level is just a feeling that you can't buy anywhere. I did it a few times in high school and then a couple more times in summer ball in college. So it's just a feeling that you can't buy anywhere else, and it's the best feeling ever. But I think what helped me the most transitioning from high school to college was playing for the Walla Walla Sweets in the West Coast League as a incoming freshman to college. I kind of got to skip all those growing pains that you learn in the fall of college, and I got to get that done in the summer, so I was able to compete right away at college.
And then you mentioned Walla Walla and the West Coast League. That's a pretty solid league, and it's even a growing league, considering one of the top prospect leagues now, as it's kind of grown and enhanced what the product it has. So what things are you hoping to take away from what you learned with those programs and that team and that league to really kind of instill into the Cascade Collegiate League?
Probably the culture, for one. I played for the Corvallis Knights for two summers, and that's, in my opinion, by far the best culture I've ever played on. It starts at the top with Dan Siegel, their president, and then Brooke Knight, the manager. He's been there for a really long time. And I mean, they just make summer ball feel more important than summer ball should probably feel, and I've learned so much from those guys and just that team in general. So I kind of want to instill that type of culture and that type of learning environment and that positive environment, and it really taught me how to win at Portland right away. So because you got those Oregon State guys that play for the Corvallis Knights and all that good culture coming in together, so I think that's going to be my biggest takeaway from summer ball.
Awesome. And then, you know, looking at your career and your history, you know, you're a Division I school. That doesn't happen by accident. It takes a lot of hard work, but it also takes people behind you really pushing you and motivating you. So who would you say in your life has been kind of that motivator and the people that really have kind of got you to where you're at?
I think my high school coach, Kim Cox, has been probably the single most impactful person in my life in terms of baseball and just my faith, my school, and everything. Like, he's just always had my back throughout my career, and he never let me go into a small school or being like probably not the most athletic kid in the world, and like he still believed in me and got me pretty much to where I needed to be. And I mean, he's done that with a ton of guys. I mean, he's won hundreds and hundreds of games at the high school level, and he got inducted into the Washington Hall of Fame for coaching. So he's a really special person in my life, and someone I'm still connected to now.
Mm-hmm. And then, you know, we talked earlier about, you know, what things you want to hope to kind of pass on to the college players, but, you know, also out here at the college level, a lot of kids will watch games, especially during the summer leagues. You can see kids everywhere. What advice would you have for them as they're looking to maybe someday make it to the college level, or even someday be a coach, like what you're trying to transition into?
I would say just fall in love with the game to start with, because once you get to this level, it becomes less, I wouldn't say less fun, because I still have fun playing every day, but I would say it's more business-like. Mm-hmm. To an extent. So I think as long as you have that burning love for the game and you can carry that all the way through your career, then you don't mind doing that extra work, and you don't mind doing the things that it takes. So I think that's something that I've carried along with me the whole time, is just a desire to be really good at this game and have fun doing it. When kids come onto the field after the game, like, I love hanging out with them. I love playing catch. Like, just yesterday after the University of Washington game, there were some kids, and it's fun seeing them and seeing how much joy they play with the game. It helps kind of remind you of where you started.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much, Cameron.
Yeah, thank you.